First, we want to say thanks to everyone for turning up. If you're not aware, tonight is Charter's final session. So after tonight, we're no longer going to be delivering services from the building. Now, up until now, we've been trying to figure out solutions to try and keep certain parts of the service going. And it's proved difficult.
You might well ask, this is a ridiculous position to be in. You will have heard from tonight, there are loads of enthusiastic, talented youngsters and young adults who have a fantastic club, really well led, really dedicated workers, a building that, yes, isn't perfect, but you know, has given them space. And sadly, the organisation, like the ceiling, has fallen in on them. The question now is, where do we go? Where do they go? Where do the activities go? We've been trying, as you know, negotiations with a club up the road to try and get something going. Some of that will work. I think the football club's safe. Some of the youth sessions are safe, but we haven't got the dance sorted, haven't got the music studios sorted, haven't got the salaries of all the staff sorted. I've almost decided that there's only one way forward. We can negotiate with places to give them space, and that's fine, they'll do that. Columbo Street down the road will help. Rockingham will help. But I think we just have to go out to the big wide world out there and say next week, look guys, if you say you think young people are important, put your money where your mouth is. Charterhouse in Southwark, organisation founded out of Charterhouse School, boys private school, public school, reputable, well established, based in Surrey. I would have thought they would have had the finances to keep it going. I don't understand. I know the city's having a hard time. I know we're in the age of the credit crunch, but I just don't understand. But charitable organisations come and go, and this one is going to shrink from a great flower to a little stem, as far as I can see. We've tried to help them, we've tried to give them ideas, we've tried to get people to buy the buildings. We've done all we can, but in the end they've decided they can't keep it going financially, they just don't have the money coming in. That's their call, they have to live with the consequences of that. We have to pick up the pieces. And in the end, I'm not bothered about whether it's called Charterhouse in Southwark or Man in the Moon. We've got to have something for these young people, if we humanly can, because they are worth investing in.
Basically, like this space, it's like we used to dance in a place called Huskies. And because we have to pay over there, down here they give us a space to dance in for free. And it's much bigger than the studios they give us down there. So now it's going to be a thing where we have to go into our own pockets and spend the money that we normally use for college or university or school and rent out a dance studio instead of getting a place where we have family here that run the place that can just say, yeah, do not come and use the space, basically. So if it's not here, then we're going to have to cut dance sessions during the week because of money issues. Yeah, it is a passion. It's a passion for all of us, really. Not all of us want to take it up as a career, but like, there's a few of us that do, like Jilly, but I know everyone else like sees it as a hobby. Some of them probably want to take it up, but everyone sees it as a hobby here, innit? So it's something we do in our spare time. We don't play football and all them other activities. We dance. Everyone sees each other as brothers and sisters. Like, and we see the youth workers as mothers and dads and uncles and aunties. Like, they treat us like we're their own, innit? So it's like we built this bond. So if we go to another youth club, it's like they've already got their own little family. We're just going to come in and intrude, innit? Not saying that we can't dance there, but it's not going to be the same. Because we don't just dance here. Like, we just come here just to have a bit of fun, you know? Like, go upstairs, go to the studio sometimes and crack joke with the boys. They make us food here, things like that. Like, in other youth clubs, you won't find that type of stuff.
Yes, my baby, she must look my head. It was like we're going back to square one again. It's like finding a new place to dance. The time, we've got to sort out times again. We've got to remember that people actually have other things to do. They got homes to go to. So we've got to make it convenient and the right space for people to come to. And whereas we've made ourselves comfortable with this space and with the time that they've set us, all the families and stuff, where they're used to their kids coming back at a certain time. So whereas everything gets locked off, it's like we're back to square one. We ain't got nowhere to go.
Something you should know.